souhaite rien, ni le bien qu'on m'a fait, ni le mal, tout ça m'est bien égal.
Paris. Rue de Richelieu. This is where the Department of Manuscripts and the Historical Reading Room of the National Library of France are located. The Library of French Kings, after the French Revolution, became a national library. The National Library of France is a real treasure trove of books and artifacts. More than 30 million items are stored there. 15 million of them are books and manuscripts. It includes a very rich collection of Oriental manuscripts and folios that were brought to Paris from all over the East in the period starting from the 17th century until World War I. But let us put first things first. As soon as you come into the National Library of France, you immediately begin to feel the spirit of enlightenment. Diplomatic relations with Paris were established by the great Amir Timur. There is information about 9 historical letters which make up diplomatic correspondence between the King of France and the Timurids. Letters between Amir Timur and the European powers France and England are known to be conveyed by Catholic monks, but there is no information how these missionaries gained access to the court of Timur. In this connection, a Catholic archbishop in Iran, Monk John, who, according to historical chronicles, played a significant role between the West and the empire of Amir Timur. The National Library of France in Paris has preserved a famous letter from Amir Timur to King Charles VI of France from the Habsburg family translated into Latin, where he invites French trade missions to the capital of his vast empire, Samarkand. This document begins with the following words. This is a copy or statement of the letter from the Lord Timur Bey, which he sent to the Most Serene King of France, translated from Persian into Latin. This letter is dated August 1st, 1402. The collection of manuscripts from the East began to form there starting from the Renaissance period. Jean-Baptiste Colbert, a statesman, the head of the government of Louis XIV, played a huge role in the development of art and science in France and the acquisition of unique manuscripts. He sent enlightened Frenchmen abroad to Italy, Greece, Egypt, and Persia with a special mission to search for and buy books. This resulted in the emergence of some very valuable manuscripts from the East to France. Moreover, Colbert opened a school of Oriental languages in Paris. He encouraged scientific and academic research and initiated the opening of the French Academy of Sciences in Paris in 1666. Through numerous special expeditions to the Middle East, the Ottoman Empire, Egypt, and India, by the 17th century, French scholars and librarians made up quite a collection of Oriental manuscripts. But even earlier in France, since the 16th century, the works of great medieval thinkers, scientists, and poets who lived and made their immortal creations on the territory of present-day Uzbekistan were translated into Latin and French. Those were Al-Fergani, Al-Khwarizmi, Abu Reyhan Biruni, Ibn Sina Avicenna, Imam Al-Bukhari, Ulugbek, and Alisher Navai. These facts testify to the great interest of the French people in the legacy of the East, These translations into European languages are now stored in the National Library of France, along with manuscripts by Oriental classics in Arabic, Persian, and Chagatai. In 1544, the library possessed 1,500 volumes in Greek, Hebrew, and Arabic. Already in 1739, the first catalog of Oriental manuscripts was published in Paris. According to Dr. Francis Richard, a famous French Orientalist, former curator of the collections of Persian manuscripts at the National Library of France, in 1653, the French ambassador in Istanbul, Denis de la Éventle, purchased more than 200 Oriental manuscripts for Nicolas Fouquet, a minister for Louis XIV. A few years later, Orientalist Antoine Galland, who was the discoverer and translator of the 1001 Nights, brought 190 manuscripts from Istanbul, which became a true adornment of the library. That very collection included a unique folio of Mirajnoma. The National Library of France possesses legendary Mirajnoma, an unsurpassed masterpiece of handwritten art of the Eastern Renaissance, where many of the pages are filled with wonderful miniatures. There we can see the true visible image of the Prophet Muhammad, since before the 15th century, its portrayal on paper was allowed. In his diary, Galland noted that he discovered this manuscript on January 14, 1673. A young secretary of a French ambassador to Turkey, Galland saw this manuscript at a bookshop and bought it for 25 Ottoman piastres. Mirajnama is a great example of book art, from the cover to the last page. 60 pages in this literary monument are miniatures. It is quite obvious that the best miniaturists were involved in the creation of this manuscript. Verily, the hadith states, "Allah is beautiful and He loves beauty." Perhaps these words inspired the artist who created the miniatures with scenes of the ascension of the Prophet Muhammad to heaven, his night journey from Mecca to Jerusalem, to the Al-Aqsa Mosque. The Mirajnama text talks about the journey of the Prophet Muhammad on a horseback with a human head named Burak. They are accompanied by the angel Gabriel, who throughout the journey from heaven to hell asks the Prophet questions. I would like to return to the image of hell. It is depicted in great detail. We see scenes of punishment of liars, unfaithful wives, and etc. And in each case, Muhammad, like Dante Alighieri, is present and sees all this himself. The text is written in Chagatai using the Uyghur alphabet. The author of manuscript text is the poet Mir Haydar Telbe, who lived in the late 14th, first half of the 15th centuries. At the top of each page of the miniature, various hadiths are written in gold in small calligraphic letters. According to French Orientalists, the manuscript was created between 1436 and 1437 in Herat. There's also the name of the calligrapher, Malik Bakhshi from Herat, who held high positions at the court of the Timurids. There is reliable information that Mirajnama was created by order of Shah Shahrukh Mirza, the son of Amir Timur and the father of the great Oriental scientist Mirza Ulugbek. However, this manuscript is a convolute, and in its binding there is another work, Tazkirat al-Awliya, Anthology of Saints, written by Fakhreddin Attar. This part of the manuscript was also rewritten by the calligrapher Malik Bakhshi. According to French scholars, this folio is of great importance for the history of the development of the manuscript book in the East. But the manuscript was fully deciphered and studied only in the late 19th century by Abel Jean-Baptiste Marie-Michel Pavé de Courtelle, a Turkologist and professor of the Turkish language at Collège de France. The National Library of France boasts a truly rich collection. Many of the manuscripts illustrated with miniatures were created in Samarkand and Bukhara. Some of those created in these Central Asian cities had been kept in Indian and Iranian collections for a long time, and then they were brought to Europe along the Great Silk Road.
From the Paris collection, it's easy to see that it was links between the Shaybani court and the Mughal library, because many of the manuscripts have marks which show that it was sent to India and taken to India, and some manuscripts were, you know, like this one. This manuscript, they were restored in India, especially at the Jahangir time, because they had a huge interest in the Mawaran Nahri style. It's Mahmoud Muzareb.
Among them, there are also manuscripts that were created for the library of Mirza Ulugbek. The real gem of the National Library in Paris is Kitab Suwar al-Kawakib al-Sabita, the Book of Fixed Stars. This is an astronomical treatise by the medieval Persian scientist Abul Husayn Abdurrahman ibn Umar al-Sufi, who lived in the 10th century. The earliest surviving list, which was illustrated by the author's son and is kept in the Bodleian Library in Oxford and dates back to year 1009. Any manuscript is unique and original. Text may not be original, but a court artist receives an order for illustrations, and the customer asks to illustrate a manuscript this way and not otherwise. From this point of view, it is original. There is no other one like this. The manuscript in the National Library of France was copied in Samarkand following an order by Mirza Ulugbek for his personal library, presumably between 1430 and 1440. There is a text in the colophon of the manuscript indicating this. These drawings, Suvar, were made for the treasury of the great Sultan and exalted Hakan, ruler of the kingdoms of the Turks and Persians, Sultan, son of Sultan Zahireddin Ulugbek Kuragan. Also, on the first page of the manuscript, there is a personal ex libris of Mirza Ulugbek. Among the drawings with zodiac signs, there are 74 of them in the album. According to researchers, there is a portrait of Mirza Ulugbek himself, depicted as a Sufi. The manuscript describes various constellations. It contains more than 70 colorful illustrations of excellent quality, painted with good technique. Scholars who have studied this manuscript are sure that there is a portrait of Ulugbek depicted in a Sufi costume. Ulugbek was a fantastic astronomer. We are happy that this precious book from his library is kept in Paris. We're glad that it is available to us.
Yeah, I think we know exactly for whom it was copied.
We know exactly who it was copied for. There is a place in the manuscript where we can exactly learn who was the author of the manuscript, when, in what city it was written. We know that the manuscript was created for a particular important ruler, so I guess it's true.
Yes, I guess this is true.
How this manuscript, created in Samarkand, came to Paris remains to be investigated. Until recently, many manuscripts originating from the territory of Uzbekistan, which are valuable and high-quality examples of book art, were little known even to specialists. Since 1723, thanks to increased trade relations with the East, more than 1,800 manuscripts have been received by the National Library of France. Some manuscripts and folios, which are the legacy of Uzbekistan, are described in detail in the book by Dr. Francis Richard, Illustrated Manuscripts of Transoxiana in the Collections of France, published within the framework of the project Cultural Legacy of Uzbekistan. The Eastern collection of the library boasts some very valuable items, but today I would like to focus on those manuscripts that are in the unique legacy of Uzbekistan. These are manuscripts that were once created for royal libraries, for the library of Shahrukh, the son of the great Amir Timur, and for the library of Mirza Ulugbek. There are also manuscripts that represent the Bukharan school of the 16th century, the school of calligraphy and miniatures. Indeed, these are genuine masterpieces. Among them is the manuscript Tahwat al-Ahrar, Gift to the Noble, by Mavlana Abdurrahman Jami. The poem was written by Jami in 1481 as an imitation of poems by Nizami Genjavi and Amir Hasrav Dehlavi. The stories in these poems are written with a didactic purpose and have some mystical coloring. Jami was a Sufi from the Naqshbandi order, and the text of his poem was a great success throughout Central Asia, as it served to spread the teachings of his brotherhood. The list, which is kept in Paris, was copied by the famous calligrapher Sultan Ali Mashhedi in Herat, the capital of the Timurid Sultanate. In the colophon of the manuscript, the date is listed, 905 Hijri, which corresponds to 1499-1500s. French scholars claim that this manuscript was later located in the Mughal Imperial Library. Literally, this text reads like this: "I will not let the hem of such beauty as you out of my hands without a struggle, because at the cost of many bitter tears, I have found you." Apparently, the manuscript was previously kept in the libraries of the emperors Akbar and Jahangir. In the miniatures, we see some very popular scenes where a young man is begging his beloved girl not to go on a trip and holding her by the hem of her dress. There is an opinion that the miniatures were inserted into this manuscript later, since they have no direct connection with the text of the poem by Jami. The National Library of France has a unique manuscript, Gulistan, by Muslihiddin Saadi Shirazi. It was rewritten in Bukhara under the guidance of Sultan Mirak Munchi, a kitabdar and the chief curator of the library. The richly illustrated manuscript is a masterpiece of book art. The manuscript was rewritten in 1543 by the famous calligrapher Mir Ali. The style of page design is very close to the examples of the Herat art of manuscript design. The text of the Persian couplets glorified this poem. This extraordinary Gulistan, which makes paradise jealous, is like an ocean on whose shores pearls are thrown. This is a casket in which precious pearls are collected. The colophon of the manuscript records the exact time of its creation. It reads, during the reign of Sultan Muzaffar ad-Din Abdulaziz Khan Bahadur, at the end of the month of Rabi al-Awwal, year 950, which corresponds to 1543. The miniatures of this manuscript illustrate how the story of the first chapter is told in the scene with two fighters. This miniature is a young wrestler fought by his teacher. The miniature reproduces the same scene which illustrated the works of both the highly revered Saadi and the extremely popular Jami. Another work by Muslihiddin Saadi Shirazi, Bustan, was copied in Nastaliq script. This is how handwritten books were decorated in Bukhara in the 16th century. According to the colophon, it was rewritten by the calligrapher Mir Hussein al-Husseini al-Khatib. In addition to the refined and colorful design of the initial pages, Bustan Saadi contains four miniatures illustrating the text. Researchers claim that the images in the miniatures are very similar to the images developed by Kamaleddin Behzad, the famous Herat artist. And although the miniatures, King Darius and the Shepherd, the Dance of the Sheikh, the story of a man who fell from a tree, the audacity of a dervish and the mercy of the government, all have a connection with the works by Behzad's student, Mahmoud Muzahib. French scholars do not give any decisive evidence that the miniatures were created by this artist. The Bukharan School of Book Art also includes the folio Lisan At-Tayar, The Language of Birds, by the great Alisher Navoi, rewritten in 1552-1553. Navoi's famous work is illustrated with six miniatures. One of them has the date and place of the creation of the manuscript, 1960 Hijri, Bukhara, inscribed in it. It is necessary to add that a number of lists by the great Alisher Navoi were created not only in Herat, but also in Bukhara during the reign of the Shaybanids. One of the poems from Lisan At-Tayar is dedicated to Sultan Hussein Baykara. The poem tells that all birds in the world realize that they are far from their king, and they fly in search of him on a difficult journey, during which various events occur. The miniatures illustrate these very events, which are described in the poem. In one of them, we see a meeting of Sufis watched by a woman from behind a curtain. Another manuscript that the National Library of France is proud of is that by Abdel Allah Hatifi, who was the nephew of Mawlana Abdurrahman Jami. It illustrates the poem Khusrau and Shirin, a very popular in the East. Earlier, the anthology of Persian poets belonged to the Imperial Library of the great Baburids, according to the seal of Shah Jahan preserved in the manuscript. This manuscript, small in format, is decorated with two miniatures. The artist reproduced familiar images without paying much attention to the text. The miniatures in the manuscript are not directly related to the content of the Ghazals, which are a selection of Persian love poems. The list of the famous Persian epic poem Shahnameh, the Book of Kings, created by Ferdowsi between years 977 and 1010, tells about history of Iran and its ancient dynasties before the emergence and dissemination of Islam. The manuscript is dated to the 16th century. It contains 47 miniatures. This manuscript was acquired by the French National Library in 1891. Unfortunately, it does not contain text indicating in which court workshop in Bukhara or Samarkand it was created. The National Library of France has a separate album made up of various miniatures with familiar subjects and exceptionally exquisite calligraphic inscriptions. Mirajnama and folios with the works by the great Alisher Navoi, Bustan by Saadi and Shahnameh by Ferdowsi, Gazelles by Hafiz, all these are priceless treasures of our legacy, which are stored here in the National Library of France. So many great names and so many amazing pages of history. Thanks to the Cultural Legacy of Uzbekistan in World Collections Project, Today, we had the opportunity to introduce you to them. I am Shahnoza Ganiyeva. Thank you for your attention.